factors affecting Hardy-Weinberg law. The first factor which affects the Hardy-Weinberg law is mutation. We said that in the conditions which Hardy-Weinberg law should fulfill, that mutation should not occur. If mutation happened, then it should be occurring in the both the ways or in both the directions. Agar mutation hoga to usko dono directions mein hona chahiye, varna nahi hona chahiye. And if by chance mutation happened, agar mutation by chance ho jata hai, then the allele frequency or the gene frequency will not remain constant, because mutation is the sudden or the rare and the random process or the discontinuous inheritance of the characters. तो अब ये discontinuous inheritance हो जाएगा in the single generation, then how would be the allelic frequency will remain constant? So there is no place of mutation in the Hardy-Weinberg law. The second factor is which affects the Hardy-Weinberg law is recombination. What is recombination? Recombination occurs only during the meiotic divisions. We have also studied earlier that recombination in the factors affecting the genetic variations. Recombination is the crossing over of the non-sister chromatid chromosomes. In that, the two non-sister homologous non-sister chromatids, when they cross over with each other, they transfer some of the genetic materials, and this happened during the second meiotic division when the gametes have to be formed. जब gametes बनने वाले होते हैं during the second meiotic division, then at that time the two sister chromatids or the two sister chromosomes, they cross over with each other, and by crossing over it means that they are sharing their genetic material, or there is some kind of transfer of the genetic material. So due to the transfer of the genetic material, recombination will be happen. This recombination occurs during gamete formation in second meiotic division. This recombination will results into the formation of varied recombinants. Due to this recombination, varied recombinants will be formed. तो अगर ये recombinants बनेंगे, this type of varied recombinations will be formed. So how will the genetic frequency or the gene frequency or allele frequency, that will remain constant? So the recombination also should not occur in the population which is going to represent, or in which the allele frequency is constant. It the recombination should not happen in that type of population. It should be the constant, the allele frequency should be the constant. Third one, the third factor is gene migration. So what is gene migration? The movement of the genes from one place to the another place is called as gene migration. Movement of genes. is called gene migration. Now, this gene migration can be of two types. One is immigration and another one is immigration. One is emigration and another one is immigration. These are two types of gene migration. Emigration means moving out of the genes. If the genes are moving out from the given population, then it will represent the emigration type of gene migration. And in immigration, if the genes are moving in, if the genes are moving in any certain population, then this type of moving of genes from some other place and involving in a population, then it will be called as immigration type of gene migration. So, this moving out of genes or the emigration or immigration should be in a bulk amount. That is, if more number of genes are being moving out, then it will be noticeable, and if more number of genes are coming in a certain population, then only it will be noticeable. This gene migration is affected only when the population is big. This gene migration is affected only when only in the small type of population. That agar small population hoga and from that small population certain genes are moving out or certain genes are moving in, then only it will be affected. From a big population, if a small amount of genes are moving, then it will be, or that population will not be affected. When only those individuals or that moving genes are going to affect certain population, that which are having the very very different kind of gene pool. The individuals which are having the very different kind of gene pools, jinke paas mein bahut different genes hai, or we can say that a small population that is having the different types of genes. If that type of population is emigrated or immigrated, then will be affected, then the gene frequencies will be affected. If the small population is there, or we can say that if a large, from a large population only the small amount of genes are being migrated, then that will be not affected. From a small population certain genes have been immigrated or emigrated, then it will be affected. So this was the third factor, gene migration, that will going to affect the Hardy-Weinberg law. The fourth one is genetic drift. We have also studied this genetic drift earlier. What is the meaning of genetic drift? The moving out of some population, or the elimination of certain genes or the certain alleles from a population due to any of the reason, is called as genetic drift. Elimination of genes or alleles from a population. Elimination of the genes or alleles from a population due to any reason. This could be any disease or death of that particular population that will be having that certain type of, or the particular type of gene, or due to any endemic reasons, that gene or that allele has been eliminated from a population, then it will be called as genetic drift. Now, this genetic drift is also called as Swale-Wright effect, on the basis of the name of the founder, or we can say on the basis of the name of the scientist. This is also called as Swale-Wright effect. And this genetic drift can also be explained on the basis of founder effect. What is founder effect, or what does this founder effect say? It says that from a population, if a small number of individuals that are being eliminated, or that small number of individuals that move out of this population, then and they are going to reside at the new place, then this small population which is going to move out of their old place and they are going now to the new place, this small population is called as founder. And when they are going to live at that new place, they are going to multiply, they will reproduce. So they are going to form a new population of their own individuals. So this new population which have been transferred or which have been moved out from one place and they are going to reside at the another place and they started reproducing there and formed their own population, they have been having their own gene frequencies, and the population that will be living there for a longer period of time, or that older population that will be living at that new place, they will be having another type of gene frequency. So due to this genetic drift, that due to the movement of certain individuals from one place to the another place and they form their own population there, due to the this kind of drift in the population, the gene frequency has been changed. So this type or this founder effect is represented the genetic drift. And this genetic drift is the another factor that is going to harm or that is going to affect the Hardy-Weinberg law. So what this founder effect said, or we can say that from this this founder effect can also be understood by one more effect, that is bottleneck effect. What this founder effect said ki kuch individual, certain individuals which were living say as this place, certain individuals were living and they moved out, so this population is called as founder and they went to the new place, say to the this place, and certain individuals or certain populations were also living there. So when this founder population goes there and when they started living there, they also started reproducing and they formed their own type of population. But these organisms have different gene frequencies, and these organisms, they are having the different gene frequencies. So by the arrival of this founder over this new place, the gene frequency of this place is changed. So this represents that due to the genetic drift, this has been the gene frequency of the one place is changed. So the genetic drift is the another factor which is affecting the Hardy-Weinberg principle. Now the bottleneck effect, it shows that, or we consider that this is one bottle. this bottle is having very narrow mouth and this bottle is filled with some colored stones. This bottle is covered with various types of colored stones. And when we keep this bottle inverted, then some of the pebbles or some of the stones will come out of this. So, suppose that only the blue colored of stones are coming out of this. We are supposing that the same type of stones have been come out of this bottle. So, when this population of the blue colored stone, we consider this as the population of the individuals of the living organisms. So, when they came out of their own place and suppose this is one new place or the new region where they are going, and here also some of the individuals were living, or we can say that some stones were kept earlier, from earlier here these stones are considered as the living organisms. So, when this colored stone that we have considered as the population of the individuals, when this fall out at one place or at the new region, then as the nature of the living organism, they will start reproducing. Wo reproduce karna start kar denge. So, because of that reproduction, they will form their own population of the individuals, they will increase their own individuals and they will form their own gene frequency. And the individuals which were present already at that place, they were also having their own gene frequency. So, due to the presence of the new individuals, the gene frequency of the older one, of the gene frequency of that place has been affected. So, this was all about the genetic drift. The fifth factor or the fifth reason that which is going to affect the Hardy-Weinberg principle is natural selection. The natural selection should not occur in that population. If the natural selection happens, then only that individuals will be selected that which are having the specific trait. So, agar sirf specific trait or the specific character wale individuals hi nature ke dwara chune jayenge, then also the gene frequency is going to be affected. So, these were the five factors. The first one was the mutation. So, no mutation should be happening here. No mutation should present. The second one is the recombination. Recombination occurs during the gamete formation time and in the second meiotic division, due to the formation, due to the recombination, certain recombinants will be formed. So, due to the formation of this recombinants or due to the exchange of the genetic materials between the sister chromatids, the gene frequency will be affected, or we can say that the genetic variation will appear in the population. That genetic variation we have also studied earlier in the modern concept or in the synthetic theory of the evolution. Now, the third factor is gene migration, that is movement of the genes by the emigration or immigration of the genes in a certain population. The Hardy-Weinberg, or we can say that the gene frequency or the allele frequency is affected. And the fourth one is genetic drift. Due to the genetic drift, the gene frequencies are affected. And the fifth one is natural selection. So, these were the five factors which are going to affect the Hardy-Weinberg law. Now, The questions are generally asked from this Hardy-Weinberg principle or the Hardy-Weinberg law. It is very important from the exam point of view, and they generally ask the questions on the this factors affecting the Hardy-Weinberg principle and the conditions which are going to fulfill the Hardy-Weinberg law. And they are also going to ask some of the numericals question that will be will solve now. The first question is, or before that we will write the expression of the Hardy-Weinberg law. P square plus Q square plus 2PQ equals to 1. This is the expression, and the first question that we are going to discuss is, in a large population, the law is going to fulfill its first condition, that the population should be large. So, in a large population, the frequency of recessive allele is 0.3. The frequency of recessive allele. Here we are talking about the recessive allele. So, what has given we have? Q. Recessive allele, only single one. So, the value of Q is given here. Now, we have to find out frequency of dominant allele . The proportion of homozygous recessive, the proportion of homozygous dominant, and fourth, proportion of heterozygous condition. Here, in a large population, the frequency of the recessive allele is 0.3. That is, we have given the value of Q, the single Q. When we are talking about the alleles, then we are talking about the single allele or the single single one, that is Q. So, we have given the value of Q, and the first one we have to find out the frequency of the dominant allele. Here also we have to find out the individual frequency. So, the first one we have given the value of Q, and we know that P plus Q equals to 1. P plus Q equals to 1. So, if we are given the value of Q, so we will fill it here. P plus 0.3 equals to 1, and P equals to 1 minus 0.3 equals to 0.7. So, the value of P is 0.7. Now, the second one, the proportion of homozygous recessive. Homozygous recessive, that is, we have given the Q equals to 0.3, and homozygous recessive will be Q square. It will be 0.09, okay, or we can say that 9%. The third one, that is proportion of homozygous dominant. Homozygous dominant, we have already, or we have found out the frequency of the dominant allele. So if P equals to 0.7, then P square will be equal to 0.49. So this is the proportion of homozygous dominant. And the fourth one, we have to find out the proportion of heterozygous condition. So heterozygous condition is 2PQ. So 2 into what is the value of P? 0.7 we have find out, and the value of Q 0.3. So it will be 2 into 0.21 and it will be 0.42. So these are the frequencies, or these were the answers we have find out. The frequency of the dominant allele is 0.7. The proportion of the homozygous recessive is 0.09 or 9%. Dominant one 0.49 or 4th one, heterozygous condition is 0.42. So these are the 4 answers. In the next video, we will discuss some more questions of this Hardy-Weinberg principle. And you people also do some of these questions, or practice some of these questions, and we will also solve some of the questions.